What is up, everyone? This is Vlad, the Crypto Trader here. Today we're going to cover the concept of dollar cost averaging, a strategy that I personally use myself, and I think it's really nice as it takes that passive approach that, for example, trading doesn't give you. And if you've never heard about the strategy, it's completely alright. We're going to briefly cover what it actually comprises of, as well as introduce to some advantages that I personally see in it. So definitely stick around if you want to learn about dollar cost averaging. So the concept of dollar cost averaging is quite simple. You just pick something that you see rising over the long term, and rather than putting all your money on it at once, you just split that big amount of money that you have into smaller like sections, right? And you put in, you buy, you know, that commodity, that stock, could be water stocks, for me it's Bitcoin, maybe gold, silver. And rather than putting it all at once, you say, okay, every month I'm going to buy an X amount, which I don't mind to lose on this thing that I see rising over the long term. And the main advantage of this strategy is that you go around this risk of making the decision at the wrong point in time. So let's say Bitcoin was trading at 10,000, right? And 2 weeks later, it's trading at 5,000. So if we had bought that Bitcoin at 10,000, right, now I only have 5,000 left. But if I split my investment in certain parts, then my risk is decreased as I still have a lot of capital left on the side where I can buy the Bitcoin at 10,000 as well as on 5,000. And so over time, the idea is that your risk and your average entry is also averaged out to a nice price. So what do I see as an advantage to this? First, it aims to be stress-free because firstly, you always invest what you can afford to lose, and it's a completely passive approach. So it's not like trading, you know, watching the charts constantly and making those stressful decisions, I would say. And, you know, decision after decision, even though you're not physically being challenged, it's always a lot of energy going, you know, being spent on your brain activity. And so rather than actively trading the market, you're just being a passive player in it, and you can use your most valuable asset, which is your time, somewhere else. So you can, you know, your attention is free to go, essentially. The second main advantage which I see of it is that it makes investment a habit. So it's like a second savings account, but not really, as you're an active market participant. But at the same time, it makes, you know, setting up some amount of money which you're comfortable with losing aside and actually investing into your future. And I guess the concept which I'm trying to reach here is delayed gratification. So rather than having that extra 100, 200, 1,000, whatever extra money that you would have per month, you just set that aside and just let it slowly compound and slowly rise over time. Also, investing generally just diversifies you. So rather than having all of your money saved up in the bank, you buy some Bitcoin, you buy some gold, you buy some water stocks, or whatever it is, you just buy stocks, I don't care. Just the idea of investment makes you better off as you're generally trying to think about your future and, as I've said, delay that gratification of having that money now. Last but not least, the advantage of dollar cost averaging is that it averages down your entry to a decent price. Let's check out this graph, for example, right here. So if we quickly go over this chart, we see that the average price and kind of our first investment decision with the total of amount of $8,000 could be made at $10 of that stock in one go, right? So your average unit cost would be $10, as you see at the top. But if we split those $8,000 into $1,000 each month, and as you can see, each month you'd catch the stock at different levels. So the first month we catch it at $10, the second month we catch it at $14. And you know, there are a few months where we catch it at lower price levels that we would catch it if we had purchased it in the first month at $10. And so as you can see at the bottom, of course this is just an example, but the average unit cost would be $9.61. And so actually you have averaged down your entry to a better price. And that's exactly one of the key components behind the idea of dollar cost averaging. You decrease your risk by not putting everything you have in the market at one go. And you also, of course, expect the thing that you're buying to go down in price sometimes. And you're completely all right with it. Actually, you should be happy that you can afford such a bargain. And have and it's ready, boom, we buy it, we put it aside, and just store it. I honestly think for the average investor who's not much into the markets but would still like to be a participant, this is one of the best ways to beat the market. As I've said, you just lower down your risk, you of course hope to have a good entry, but just let's think about it. If the stock keeps going up, right, you would still buy it every month, or could be every week, could be every day. It's really up to you to decide how often you would like to invest in that thing that you're buying. But even if it goes up over time, you already own some of it, and if it goes lower, you have some cash on the side so you can buy more of it. So it's really a win-win here. And I think for the brain, that makes it much easier, as you have that abundance on left on the side, ready, you know, ready to fire whenever you need. Rather than having to make that stressful decision like, is this the right time to buy? Is in 2 months the right time to buy? And looking at these fundamentals and the technicals, and just get that all off the window, just throw it away, and just follow the plan of every month I'll buy X amount of this thing that I see going up over the long term. Could be every month, could be every week, could be every day. The time frame is for you to decide on this. But I hope that after this exact moment, you see the advantages that I see behind dollar cost averaging. And and I hope to have provided you some value behind this strategy. So leave a like and subscribe to this channel in case you would like to see more of such similar content as this video. If you have tried dollar cost averaging, definitely leave your experience below in the comments. And I hope to see you the next time around. Take care.